App development involves a lot of tasks that aren't directly related to the app itself. Doesn't make it any less crucial for your project. Case in point, landing pages. Many SaaS products need a landing page as part of a marketing campaign and ecosystem. Let's learn how the best of the best do it. Nah, not me. Let's look at some actual great examples. Three parts to this video. We're going to look at real-life examples of successful app landing pages and how across B2B and B2C, across different genres, a lot of good landing pages are formulated. They may not be identical twins, but they share the same DNA. To really notice these patterns, we'll need to understand some landing page theory. So that comes first, then the examples. And I'm not sure exactly when in the video, but once I think we've covered enough theory and examples, I'm going to share a free resource for you to easily build high conversion landing pages. Sounds good?
Sounds great, Adrian.
All right. Let's dive into landing page theory. The first thing you should be asking is, what would I, an app developer, know about marketing theory? Good question. I have a good answer. It's not my theory. This comes from a guide by Harry Dry, who runs a marketing newsletter with 130,000 subscribers, including yours truly. His website, Marketing Examples, is a treasure chest for marketing tips, and I don't want to sound like a fanboy, but I've been following Harry for a while. It's the real deal. So the theory is there's two parts of a landing page. What's immediately visible, aka above the fold, and what the user scrolls to, aka below the fold. For the immediately visible portion, this is what a good landing page does. Number one, explain the value provided. This is done by headline, which should make it immediately clear what the product is. For extra credit, you can add a line addressing your user's major pain point. Number two, explain how that value is delivered. This is done with the subheading, the smaller text right after the headline. Keep it as simple as possible, but don't be afraid to get specific. Make sure it explains how your product can do what the headline says. Number three, let the user visualize it. This is where your choice of hero image comes into play. Harry recommends showing the app in action wherever possible, and one of the examples we'll look at later does this super well. Number four, make it believable. This is where you showcase the most impactful social proof you have, keeping in mind who you want to attract and convert. Number five, make taking the next step easy. Call to action. It's the button that leads click. What else you want me to say? That's above the fold. Let's recap. We have explained the value provided, done with the headline. Explain how it's delivered, done with the subheading. Let the user visualize it, done with the hero image. Make it believable, done with social proof. Make taking the next step easy, aka your CTA button. Here's the kicker. Harry says a page has 5 seconds to demonstrate this to a fresh lead. We'll also need to look at below the fold, but let's see above the fold in action first. B2B example, Stripe. Stripe is a financial services app that was founded in 2010 as a direct alternative to PayPal. In 2022, it made close to $4 billion in revenue, and as of 2023, it has a global market share somewhere in the 20s if you average various sources. When a lead lands on their site, this is what they see. I like the headline. It tells you that Stripe isn't just a payment gateway. There's more to it. But it's still clear enough that anyone will understand that whatever more is, it facilitates online payments and transactions. Step number one, explain the value provided, check. We look at the subheading and it becomes even clearer. Use Stripe's software and APIs to accept payments, send payouts, and manage their businesses online. Okay, so that's how it's a payment infrastructure. Step two, explain how the value is delivered, checked. We look at the visual and it becomes even clearer. Definitely showing their app in action here. They've gone with a web and one mobile screenshot on top of it. Not unusual when there's a clear difference between web and mobile usage. The web view shows an account dashboard. Leads will know that they can easily see an overview of money coming in and going out on a nice legible interface. A lot of Stripe's customers are business owners, so this dashboard is a big deal. The mobile screen shows what the user experience of their customers will be like. A modern, simple, friendly, and high conversion checkout page. Step three, let the user visualize it. Triple check. If you look for social proof, we find it right away. They've got it in two parts. One of it is actually in the subheadings where they say millions of businesses of all sizes, from startups to large enterprises, use Stripe. This is then reinforced by that list of client logos, which, by the way, they've customized by region. This is for their Malaysia page. If I visit their Indonesian URL, I would get this. Step 4, make it believable. Check. If a lead is convinced and wants to register or contact their sales team, the CTA buttons are right there. Step 5, make taking the next step easy. Check. B2C example, InDrive, formerly InDriver. InDrive is an international ride-hailing service operating in 47 countries. With more than 175 million downloads, they are the second largest ride-sharing and taxi app worldwide. A name change from InDriver to InDrive in 2022 came with a new pitch. But by now, they're already big. I want to look at the original, the one that made them big. Here's what it looks like. These guys are competing against Grab and Uber. And that headline and subheading combo very clearly explain their value and how it's delivered. Headline says fare rides, and the subheading explains it's achieved by user offering a price instead of being told a price like with Grab. It doesn't say it, but we're thinking it. Step 1 and 2, check. Now, I gotta be honest, I'm not really feeling the visual. Nothing wrong with it, but it just looks like any other e-hailing app. InDrive has a strong USP. Users can offer a fare. Show it. Keep this photo, put a mobile screenshot on top of it showing the offer in action. I got these screenshots from their Play Store page. Put this on the photo and we understand, this guy offered a fare and the driver counter-offered. As it is, it feels incomplete. Something you want to be careful of when designing your landing page. Step 3, no check. On the plus side, social proof all over the page here. We see impressive app stats below. We see the number 2 in the world little circle up there. Step 4, triple check. And yes, the CTA button is clear as day. Step 5, check. So there you go. We still have to look at what happens below the fold, but first, I want to show you how to easily build landing pages as good as any of these examples in, I don't know, in an hour? If I understand you, you want to build apps that make a difference. But you could have the best app in the world. If your landing page looks sketchy, customers aren't going to trust you. Put yourself in their shoes. They don't know you or your product. All they see is a potential scam. It's no different from a rundown or complete physical storefront. The signboard says it's a shop, but everything else screams money laundering. Imagine losing potential customers to an inferior competitor because it had the more presentable landing page. At the same time, you don't have unlimited resources to dedicate to building custom pages. What you need is a tool that lets you easily and quickly create a high quality presentable landing page, a digital storefront that gives customers a great first impression. And it sure would be nice if the tool was free, which is why I've teamed up with HubSpot, who have kindly sponsored this video. HubSpot has a whole suite of free tools made for people like you. And in this case, I recommend using their free drag and drop website builder, CMS Hub Free. It comes with an intuitive drag and drop editor that will let you customize the page based on your needs without needing to code. If you've never built a page before, don't worry. There are helpful guides that will walk you through the system for the first time. Also, if you already have your own website, you can host your page on a custom domain, or of course, HubSpot can host it. There are tons of website and landing page specific templates with placeholders for all the elements on this list in every variation you could want. If you are not much of a designer, just plug and play. My scriptwriter Ashraf tried to improve the design of a landing page, and this is what he showed me. I don't think a web page can be radioactive, but this might just give you superpowers if you stay too long. This is on Ashraf, by the way. The original template looks awesome, and you can easily apply the takeaways from the case studies. If your design skills are like Ashraf, HubSpot CMS was made for you. Don't touch the arrangement, everything's there and looks great, just plug and play. The ultimate selling point is what you get beyond the builder. You can take advantage of HubSpot's entire CRM ecosystem. You can connect your landing page to their suite of marketing, sales, customer service, and data automation tools. But that can come later. For now, sign up for an account, pick a landing page template, and get to work. Link in the description. And now, we go below the fold. Back to theory, below the fold. I wish this were called something else. Whenever I see fall, I just think of laundry. Anyways, if a lead is interested but still unconvinced and they scroll down, this is what the rest of the landing page should deliver. Number 1, Make the value concrete. If leads scroll down, they're intrigued, but they're also wondering, could this be bullshit? This is where you explain features in a way that clearly shows your app can deliver as promised above. This is also where you address objections, security, complexity, pricing, and many more. Don't be afraid to get technical if you have to. Number two, inspire action. This needs a specific kind of social proof. The one above the fold is really just to show you are not a scam, unless your product is how to design a scam. But then, what if you don't deliver? You promise to help your users scam, but then you scam them. Does that mean you're not a scam or a super scam? Anyways, I digress. Here you want social proof that makes the lead go,
"Damn, I want what that guy's having."
Number three, tie up loose ends. Anything else users might be wondering, this is where you include and address it in the form of an FAQ. Number four, repeat your call to action. Harry makes a good point here. Our CTA above the fold is usually short because the leads are digesting a lot of things at once, and a long CTA button could make things messy. At the bottom, we have more space. And so the CTA can benefit from a message that reminds the lead of what they get when they click on that button. Let's recap. Make the value concrete by discussing features and objections. Inspire actions through specific social proof. Tie up loose ends with an FAQ. Repeat your call to action with a second, more detailed CTA. I think the FAQ section isn't compulsory. It is to tie up loose ends, so include it if you have loose ends. Let's look at some below the fold examples. And because they call me Mr. Unpredictable, we'll start with a B2C app. B2C example, Body by Beachbody. Body is a workout and diet app that lets you create custom workout plans and meal plans tailored to your goals and lifestyle. They have 1 million downloads on Google Play, and in 2022, their parent company reported a digital subscription sales of 2 million. We head to their page and we get this. The text is not as direct as the earlier examples, but the positive messaging and that picture of just a normal looking person does wonders. You know it's a workout product. Now we scroll down. Here, they are making the value concrete by showing the different features the app has. You have all these different fitness blocks. Then you have help with your nutrition, followed by mindset. So it moves from being about fitness to health, but it definitely feels like it delivers on the offer at the top. Step one, make the value concrete, check. Now we see social proof that inspires action. The users in their testimonials and the models in their visuals are connected. Just everyday people who want to get healthy and feel healthy. If we read the testimonials, there's no mention of, "I got a six pack." Instead, they talk about how they can play with their kids, be with their family, become confident. Body knows that birds of a feather flock together. Step two, inspire action, triple check. And last, we see a second, more detailed CTA with some added social proof. Step four, repeat your CTA, check. No FAQ, but it doesn't seem to be needed here. And neither is it in our last example, which is our B2B example, Groove HQ. Oh, okay, Ashraf, talk about a throwback. Groove HQ was the first content piece I did when I got back into YouTube. It's special to me because the founder, Alex, is a non-tech guy, and I'm all about helping non-technical founders, so it's amazing to see inspiring people like him. Anyways, we go to their page and we get this. Sorry, I forgot to introduce them. Groove HQ is a help desk platform that supports businesses with their ticketing systems. It was founded to be a simple, no-frills alternative to bigger options like Zendesk, which they feel is too bloated for smaller operations. According to the last statement from Alex we could find, Groove is making $10 million a year. Their above the fold is perfect. Let's scroll down. We see their features that make their offer concrete. Then we see some social proof from other business owners. And finally, a hell of a second CTA. Still no FAQ, and I still don't care. And just like that, your landing page has all the elements needed to convert efficiently. Of course, you need to know what efficiently means. According to WordStream, the average landing page conversion rate is 2.35% across industry, and the top 25% hit 5.31% or higher. That number obviously includes a huge range. So you'll want to do some research on what's an acceptable conversion rate for landing pages in your niche. If you want to understand that, I would suggest reading that WordStream article in full, link in description. Now, the Groove HQ mention has gotten me nostalgic. Yes, their landing page works according to Harry's formula, but Alex as a founder is someone we can all learn a few things from. Some are what to do, some are what not to do. All of which I cover in this video, exploring how Alex as a non-tech founder created a super successful SaaS. Please subscribe and like this video if you haven't. Leave a comment. What would you like to hear me talk about? Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out HubSpot's CMS Builder and let's see what we can learn from Alex.